Hello and welcome to Hangin' with Jennifer. My name is Bruce Garber, producer of the show. We're coming to you from a Google Plus on-air hangout, and we'll be bringing you stories from around the world, from entertainment to conversations. Now let me introduce the host of Hangin' with Jennifer, Jennifer Buck.
Everybody, and welcome to Hanging with Jennifer. So glad you're back. My name is Jennifer Buck, and we've had a really great time talking to some really interesting people that are doing their part to change the world and make it a better place. And I've been so honored to have the guests that I've interacted with over the last couple weeks. I'm so glad you're coming back. This is such a great thing. You know, today I've got somebody in that I really admire. She has absolutely left her mark on this world. Her name is Lisa Laude out of Chicago. And of course, I've got my sidekick and co-host, Tim Jones, that you all know. He's always with me every week. Hey, Tim, how you doing?
Pretty good, Jennifer. You know, in the last interview, we were talking about how our actions and reactions have such a deep ripple effect. So I've been putting forth a lot of effort to think about my reactions to have a positive effect.
I love it.
And I'm really looking forward to meeting Lisa.
Yeah, you know what, and I love that, because I know when Joe talked about intention, it was all about making the choice to be positive. And that's what I love about Lisa. And Tim, I know you're going to enjoy this, because Lisa is one of the most intentional people I've ever met. She knows what she wants to do. She knows what needs to be done. And she just really creates change everywhere she goes. So hi, Lisa. I'm glad you're here.
Hi, Jen. Thanks for having me on the show. Hi, Tim.
Hello.
Hey, I am so glad you're here, Lisa, because, you know, I talk about you all the time, and that it only takes one person to create change and to really, really help other people. Mm-hmm. And I know that a lot of times we think I'm just one, but that one is enough, and that one person can create such change. And what a lot of people don't know about, you know, what you've done, and what I'm really looking forward to introducing them to, is the impact you've had on the world since the Haitian earthquake that happened. Haiti earthquake happened on January 12th in 2010. Yeah. And being of Haitian descent, and you are the first generation living here in America, I know that this hit you 2 years ago very, very hard. How was that for you to go through that moment?
Jen, well, let me say this. My husband was actually in Haiti when the earthquake took place. And I was, you know, married just for a few years. And I was actually on my way home. I had trained that day. And he called and said, honey, I just wanted you to know that we've just had an earthquake. I'm okay. And I can't, you know, continue the conversation. We'll talk again soon. And I thought, oh, how nice of him to call and let me know. And didn't think much about it until I got home. And when I got home, I mean, everyone was glued to the television and, you know, crying and distraught. And that's when I realized what type of earthquake Haiti had actually experienced. It was a 7.0.
Yeah, 7.0 is huge, especially in a third world country where they don't have the infrastructure to be able to handle that level of devastation. And I know that, you know, we all witnessed the tragedy of you know, the after effects of what happened there. And it had to have rocked your world.
Absolutely. So immediately I tried to call him back, and I couldn't reach him for the next 48 hours. Oh. And, you know, on the news, they were saying that a lot of people died in the what do they call those after effects, right?
Aftershocks.
The smaller aftershocks. Thank you. The smaller ones. And I mean, my heart was just, you know, in disarray until I spoke with him once again. But once I did, I realized I was blessed enough for him to live through this.
Yes.
Now, what do I do? Do I sit back and say, thank God it wasn't me?
Yeah.
Or do I intentionally, positively decide to do something?
Yeah.
Do something positive about what happened. And, you know, everyone was still sitting in front of CNN, and Facebook had just really started to grow. And I logged on to Facebook and just started connecting with people and finding out, hey, what can we do to help?
No, Lisa. Oh, sorry. Go ahead. I'm sorry to interrupt. Go ahead.
I was going to say, a girlfriend of mine that I hadn't spoken to for maybe 20 years, she's a doctor in the Florida area, and she said, you know what? I'm ready to go. Well, they weren't letting any flights into Haiti.
Right.
And she said, if you can get me on a plane and you can get me to Haiti, I'll go and I'll get other doctors to go with me. And that's how our
mission.
Yes, how our mission began.
Yeah. You know, Lisa, what a lot of the viewers don't know is that you are an author. You have been a professional speaker for over a decade. And so you touch a lot of lives. And you also have a television show that's out of Chicago. But you had never really gotten into the world of philanthropy. I mean, this had never been something that you had engaged with. So I imagine if there were no planes going to Haiti, there were no supplies going to Haiti, you were up against a huge mountain. How did you, by yourself, get planes and supplies along with your friend who's a doctor there? I mean, did you have the support of big organizations, or was it something that you did on your own?
Listen, Jen, we just decided that we were going to make a difference. And we started making phone calls, and one person was connecting us to someone else and someone else and someone else. And we got in touch with these pilots who had these private jets, and they were like, hey, we'll go. And there was an organization, a small organization called Clean the World. And they put us in touch with pilots. And then my girlfriend Marie got the Claire Marie. She got the doctors. And it just started to all come together. And within a matter of 3 days, we had our first 12 doctors being flown down there. And really, we were a part of that rescue team, you know, some of the first rescue teams to hit the ground in Haiti.
It's amazing. Wow. And you know, what's incredible to me is that you did this from your home.
I did.
Social networking. And, you know, one of the things that I am slowly starting to realize is that through these social networks, we have such a huge ability to make a difference. And that can go either way. Tim, you know, you were just saying that our intention with our positive thoughts is important, but there's also that other side of it, isn't there?
Yes, there is. You can have a knee-jerk negative reaction, and it can cause a deep ripple effect also.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's a choice, isn't it? I mean, it's really a choice to do something. And I think a lot of people, Lisa, are somewhat cynical. They think that I don't want to give the big, you know, corporations money because I don't know that the money is actually going to that, you know, that disaster. Mm-hmm. And so we found that with Katrina, that a lot of people, as much money as they did get, a lot of people became very cynical again about these organizations and whether or not their money's getting there. How did you deal with that, Lisa, with people that were, I mean, they were just dealing with Lisa Laude. They weren't dealing with an organization, but I'm sure there was still some of that skepticism.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I couldn't promise any tax write-offs. All I could say is, listen, you know me, you know what I stand for, and you know what has happened. Yeah. Do you wish to, you know, take a chance on your $50 or your $5 or your $1,000 making a difference? And those who made the decision to do that helped. And those who didn't, you know, we didn't spend time on that. But we I think before the actual commercial flight started going into Haiti, we had 250 doctors who had visited Haiti.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
And shared. And then, you know what, then we said, well, we can't stop there. Okay, that was immediate need. That was, you know, emergency relief. What do we really want to do to help sustain the growth now of Haiti and you know, coming back to, or actually not coming back to, because they were in a bad way anyway, but how can we help Haiti rise once again?
And how did you do it, Lisa? Because a lot of people, you know, they gave their money and they watched the horrific images on TV. And the fact of the matter is, it goes away. There's something else that becomes news and people forget. How have you contributed? Because I know you just got back from Haiti 2 days ago, to snowy Chicago. And that had to be a total shock to your system.
Absolutely. It always is. It always is.
Absolutely. But how have you sustained that growth? How have you continued to contribute to make sure that Haiti's thriving?
Yeah, you know, I think everyone has to have a cause that they believe in, that they're willing to fight for and speak about. And it's not going to be Haiti for everybody, but for me, it is Haiti. And so I decided, you know, because I have the gift of speech or the gift of gab, right? Yeah. I decided to use my voice for those who couldn't speak in Haiti. And so just in conversation, you know, just letting everyone know what inspires me, what I'm passionate about. I connected with a non-for-profit and a for-profit organization. The for-profit organization was looking to build schools in Haiti.
Okay.
The non-for-profit organization had watched its orphanage crumble on January 12th of 2010. I connected them. They built a brand new school, 300 students from a slum area of Haiti. Now have a brand new school that they opened the doors to in September of 2011.
Wow. And you just got back from looking at the progress and seeing these children being able to...
And met the students. And I mean, when I walked into the classroom, I saw the teacher and the students and realized that this dream, this single thought from a single person turned into all of this. And all of these different individuals with those single thoughts all coming together and to see what we were able to accomplish. Jen, you got to be inspired to do more.
Oh, absolutely. And that's what I'm getting at here. You know, the fact of the matter is it takes one person. Yes. It just takes one person to make a huge difference on this planet. And that's exactly what my labor of love is with this program, is that I want people to move. I want them to act. I want them to do something. And Lisa, I want to know if you could tell your 14-year-old self something. You know, if you could tell yourself something, go back in time and tell yourself something that would absolutely inspire you to be the best you that you could be, what would that message be that you left your young self when you were struggling in life with that teen angst and whatnot? What's one thing that you would tell yourself?
You know, what I would tell myself and what I would tell my children, guard your dreams, guard your thoughts, guard your future. Be careful who you share what you were created to do in this world with, because some people aren't ready to hear it.
Yeah, I think you're right. And I think that knowing what you want to do and having that intent and doing it is what then propels us as adults who have the means, who have the drive, who have the dream to make a difference. And I think that many of us forget that we have all the resources if we just get creative and start talking about what we want to do. So one last thing, Lisa, I just want to know from you, for the people that are watching that are thinking, man, I can't go to Haiti and I can't do something that huge. I want you to just give us one thing that would possibly inspire the people that are watching to reach out and create that connection, because my firm belief is that I'm put on this planet to make every single person that I interact with better. Somehow make them better. Even if it's just one thought, one moment, one post on Google, I want to know from you, what's one thing you could leave people with that would encourage them to take action and do something with their life to help other people?
Yeah. I always ask people, what do you do to a room, or what happens to a room once you enter it? Once someone meets with you, what happens? Have you inspired them to change in any way? And if not, then your assignment is incomplete.
I love it.
We can't audience members. We must be participants of this global world that we're a part of.
Absolutely. And I think that this world is ready, and I really mean this from the bottom of my heart, I think this world is ready for a major empathy shift. And what I mean is, I think that we're ready to feel for each other again. I think we're ready to truly empathize with each other again. And I think we've become so divided that we're forgetting that we are all one. And we are brothers and sisters, and we cannot sit back and watch the famine, the pain, the lack that is around us and be okay with that. We can't wait for somebody else to do it, to take care of it, and to take action. And I just love you, Lisa, because you're that person that inspires me every day to reach out and make a difference with everybody I meet. So thank you.
Thank you, Jen. You inspire me.
Listen, guys.
Real quick, for the new year, wish you that the world and all of its opportunities, all that is good, opens up for you this year.
Thank you.
That's
you're
right.
So sweet. Thank you.
And you too, Tim.
Oh, thank you.
That's right. We can't forget Tim. Hey, listen, everybody. Thanks for joining us today with Hanging with Jennifer. I'm so happy that this is rolling and that we're meeting great people. Remember something for me. I need to hear from you. I need to know, who do you know and what are you doing that is making an impact? Because, look, we're not choosy here. We want to know about the smallest acts, the biggest acts. We want to know what you're doing through music, your art, through your photography, through your writing, just through your neighborhoods. We want to hear from you. So on behalf of my co-host, Tim Jones, as well as Bruce Garber, who is our producer that keeps this whole thing afloat, Lisa Laude, thank you for being here. And for all of you watching, I can't thank you enough for hanging with Jen another week, and we will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.